White House, where the Biden administration is speaking out about a controversial abortion law in Texas. Take a listen to this heated exchange between a male reporter and the press secretary over President Biden's view.
He believes that it's up to a woman to make those decisions and up to a woman to make those decisions with her doctor. I know you've never faced those choices, nor have you ever been pregnant, but for women out there who have faced those choices, this is an incredibly difficult thing. President believes their rights should be respected. Go ahead. I think we got to move on.
All of this comes after the Supreme Court refused to block the law overnight, which bans the procedure after 6 weeks into pregnancy. CBS reporter Skylar Henry has the latest from Capitol Hill.
In a 5-4 decision, the U.S. Supreme Court refused to block what's now the most restrictive abortion legislation in the country. Texas law SB 8 essentially bans abortions for women as early as 6 weeks into pregnancy, which is before many women realize they're pregnant. It also allows any private citizen to sue anyone who helps a woman get an abortion. In her dissent, Justice Sonia Sotomayor called the order a breathtaking act of defiance of the Constitution.
There is now a conservative block on the court that is looking to overturn Roe.
American University professor Jessica Waters says the court's refusal to act could embolden other states to pass similar laws to challenge the 1973 landmark Roe versus Wade decision.
We are returning to a time where access to safe abortion care is going to depend on where you live and how much money you have.
Meanwhile, Texas anti-abortion groups are praising the court's decision.
With this bill, we do hope to see an end to abortion.
The president has called on Congress to act. Thursday, Speaker Nancy Pelosi said the House will take up the Women's Health Protection Act, a bill that protects access to abortions when members return later this month.
We have heard for decades that this day would come. This day is here. And we have to respond.
Texas Congresswoman Lizzie Fletcher, a co-sponsor of the House bill, says for too long, abortion rights advocates have relied too much on the courts.
This should force everybody to act now. It's going to have tragic consequences for families across Texas.
President Biden has directed his administration to look into what legal tools it has to counter the Texas law. Skylar Henry, CBS News, Capitol Hill.
If the House does pass the Women's Health Protection Act, the bill is likely to face an uphill battle in the evenly divided Senate. Meanwhile, the Supreme Court will hear arguments this fall on a Mississippi law that would ban abortions after 15 weeks of pregnancy.